Rugned is his name.
Okay.
His brother is Rugned as well.
Rugned.
They both have the same name.
Okay, but they're both Rugned Odor?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know how the number one and number two, I guess.
One and one, two.
You want to be one, three?
Doc, I hate to be a mean, but how would you like to be one, three?
But apparently they were in WBC. No, I think it was during season. It was during the actual minor league season. The minor leagues system season,
oh,
whatever.
Got it.
You know.
Got it.
But they were fucking like their hazing of this other player.
Oh no!
Involved them like tying him down and jerking him off and shit.
I'm like, joke's on you. I like to get jerked off.
I just don't understand who says, you know, I think I'm gonna jerk off another dude to haze him.
I think the only way that would be hazing is if the dude was so homophobic it would like, you know, boil his blood. You know?
Yeah.
And he'd be like, oh, you're that homophobic. All right. And then I wouldn't do it. That would be the only way it would get him enough to be.
Yeah, but here's hazing. The thing. I would do what I did to.
Sacrifice.
It's funny.
How did you find the story out, first of all?
It was on the news. Oh. Fucking national news.
All right. That's weird.
I mean, because it's a huge, huge scandal.
No pun intended.
It was huge. It was huge. It was a huge, very, very large. Very, very large. The largest.
Got it.
The hugest.
Got it.
Wait, anyway. So we had a bass player.
What was his name? TB player?
His name, I know. His name was Brian.
Oh, Jesus.
I know. It should have been
singer?
TB player. No.
He wasn't a singer.
Anyway, just a bass player. He comes up to me and is like, man, it's my birthday. I've never had a birthday party. Will you please throw me a birthday party? Because I hear you throw some pretty wild parties back in my younger years.
Uh-huh.
I said, I got to see
how this is going with dicks. Got to go somewhere with dicks.
Yeah,
keep going.
Don't worry. I said,
bring all the dicks.
Dick's coming. I said, do you realize what you're asking? He said, yeah. I said, are you sure? He said, yeah, I'm sure. I said, anything goes. I said, okay. I have witnesses. Everybody here heard him say anything goes. So we had our drummer's grandmother bake him a penis cake.
Okay.
It wasn't really a penis cake. It was a cream-filled, like, dude cake.
Yeah.
We got a kielbasa sausage.
Okay.
Stuck it on there and put a pin through it. So we had a Prince Albert.
I was about to say, you put a barbell in it. Yeah. Okay.
And then this is when I worked at a certain guitar center store type place. That wasn't Guitar Center, actually.
Of course not.
No, actually, it was Zoom Music, because
it was six string instrument middle.
Six string, yeah. No, it was Zoom Music, because it was the guy that I had helped me hire the entertainment for the evening.
Mm-hmm. Is that what they call them nowadays?
Anyway, so it's the night of the party, and you know this, that, and the other. We're playing a show. At the Dirty Perch. It's not there anymore. Yeah. This story just fucking tells itself. It's so good. So here we are in the middle of the set at the Dirty Perch. And my boss, whom hired the entertainment for the evening.
Did you say whom?
Yep.
You goddamn old English speaking motherfucker. Whilst whom?
That's correct English speaking. Right. Yeah. It's not old English speaking. It's correct English speaking motherfucker. Anyway, whilst he were playing... In walks Jeff, and he's like, yeah, hey, we're here. I said, cool. Brian, take a seat. We get him in his seat in the middle of the stage. All right, everybody, Brian's birthday. I think he was turning 24 at the time. It's his birthday, blah, blah, blah. We presented him with his penis cake. Told him to blow out the candle, but it wasn't a candle. Kielbasa. And then different music starts playing over the house system, and it's like fucking dance music or whatever. And in walks a stripper. For Brian Boitano.
What would Brian Boitano do?
Yeah. We used to call him Brian Boitano, too.
I know.
Just pissed him off.
So did the stripper have a dick?
The stripper came out, you know, and our other guitar player's brother, Phil. You remember, Matt. Anyway, Matt's brother, Phil, screams out and goes, oh, yeah, let me see some titties. He's fucking drunk as shit. And this stripper gets up there and, like, fucking... dances on Brian and whatnot for a little bit, rubs all up on him, and Brian's like, yeah, ooh, and then stripper grabs the mic, happy birthday, Brian. And Phil, the same guy, said, yeah, I get to see some tits, screams from the back, holy shit, that dude has a dick. Yeah, got him a cross-dressing stripper. It was great.
I don't think I'd be friends with you after that.
So, yeah. I think he was free-balling it, too. He just rubbed his sweaty ball sack all over him.
I'm up to trying most things, but a trainee is just not one of them.
You're not on the training train?
No.
No training train for you?
Nope.
You don't want to know what it's like to impale somebody?
I really just don't want to go in your buttholes at all.
Did
you? Yeah, I heard you impale. Got it.
Yeah. Best part about having sex with a transvestite? Feels like it went all the way through.
Yeah. I've got a worse joke than that. I've got the worst joke ever I've ever heard, but I'll never tell it again.
Okay.
Good. I'm not telling it.
On break?
Sure.
Okay.
But you have children, so I don't know if I want to tell it.
It's break time.